Our next speaker is Brant Meadows.
Commissioners, I heard Brad Wilkins recently request that the jail and courthouse be the only items on the SPLOST ballot and not the rest of the court. I agree with that fiscal responsibility. The reasonable voice says, you don't have to do business with the City of Cumming. The unreasonable voice says, let me remind you that the City of Cumming buildings is paid for, yours is not. The reasonable voice says, according to SPLOST rules, Forsyth County can bypass the City of Cumming regarding Tier 1 SPLOST projects like the jail and the courthouse. The unreasonable voice says, if you bypass the City of Cumming, the city will have to raise alcohol rates. The reasonable voice says, if you bypass the City of Cumming as allowed for in SPLOST rules for Tier 1 projects, that means you aren't required to get the permission of the City of Cumming. The unreasonable voice says, the City of Cumming doesn't seem to have the inviting that you fellas have with the project list regarding the old Atlanta Road improvements. The reasonable voice says, the City of Cumming is in agreement, and they're ready to take the money if you'll give it to them. The unreasonable voice says, this ain't no blank check this time. The reasonable voice says, the City of Cumming won't need to file any lawsuits this time because what the big print giveth, the little print taketh away. Thank you.
Our next speaker is Charlotte Gardner.
Thank you.
Commissioner Pam. We've had a lot of private meetings, but I don't know of any secret meetings we've had, and I appreciate the board that's been able to come across the street, and I've come over here and us work on this, and we have a consensus of unanimous support for the projects that's been proposed by the county. I would also comment that there's a couple of speakers that spoke in reference to maybe postponing the election till next year, and of course they admitted that we have hard economic times. Well, there's no better time than to get the best prices in these economic times, and at the same time give a lot of businesses and people work to do. Spending $101 million is going to put a lot of people to work, and it's going to be a hell of a lot of business in this county. So I commend the board on what y'all have done, and thank you very much, and thank you for the speakers tonight. All of it helps.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
I'd like to add one note that I don't think anybody's brought up yet. If this all passes and the courthouse gets built, when the courthouse moves, no personnel moving in the new court building, that building will become available. And we have a lot of properties we now rent. We can then move those employees and those offices back into the old courthouse and save a lot of rent money.
All right. With that, we have our regular scheduled meeting. We're running a little behind. Without exception, Councilor, can we take a break until, say, 5:40? We'll start our meeting. Without exception, Board. Without exception, Council. We'll start our meeting. Mr. Mayor, the Council will start our meeting at 5:40.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Raise your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Councilman, do we move on to the SPLOST intergovernmental agreement, or should we start adopting minutes and consent agenda?
Mr. Chairman, I think pursuant to the modification of the agenda, it's time to go to the new business item one, which is consideration of SPLOST.
Is it coming or doesn't matter?
There's no requirement for a particular order, but I'm speaking, so perhaps it might be good for the Board of Commissioners to take it up and make a motion if you were so inclined.
All right, is there a motion from the Board?
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion to be approved of the intergovernmental agreement between Forsyth County, Georgia, and the City of Cumming, related to SPLOST projects and the percentages as presented by the county attorney.
I'd like to second that with, I'd like to second that, but also got some comment.
Mr. Chairman, I'll second the discussion.
I think it's very important that the city and county maintains a great relationship. I know there's some people on both sides of the fence. I personally, every day that I head to the county, I do drive Castleberry, or I drive Kelly Mill home, and I know those roads are not state roads. They're roads of the county and the city SPLOST share. And I know that there's been some portion that goes to the damage I do that road every time the road that I put on. That being said, I would ask the mayor and the council, as they're deciding and making their final lists, that they would consider some of the SPLOST money going to some interest of the city current look, to make it appealing for folks who would love to come into your town and make more restaurants or something such like that. I'd love to see you guys really thrive in that world. Thank you.
Thank you. Further discussion?
Yes, I just wanted, for the county projects, this, first of all, was on page two that I find in my book. You mentioned page three. I want to make sure I don't have the wrong information of what the projects are. Do you agree?
Well, I said page five, yes, it's what you said.
Okay. Take, for example, road, streets, bridges, and sidewalks, $70 million.
Yes.
What prevents, what allows a citizen to know where those will be built?
Well, the project list that was adopted at the work session is the best guide for how this money will be spent. And, you know, we went to great lengths to divide that into Project A and Project B lists. And that's the best guide. The SPLOST law is very specific that when you make representations to the voters with respect to what the projects will be and try to incentivize and induce the voters based upon those discrete project lists, that we are held to them. And that's always the danger of making too many promises, because we will be held to them even if SPLOST revenues don't come in the way they're estimated. But the answer to your question, Commissioner Voth, is that the citizens can look at our Project A list and can have comfort that we will build this project.
Thank you. Any further discussion?
One more thing. That list, will it be available online if people wanted to look it up?
Absolutely.
Prior to educating themselves?
Yes, sir. Mr. Chairman, before we, if you take a vote, I just want to ask the maker of the motion and the individual to take a second. If in making the motion, you were anticipating that you were making the motion to approve the resolution approving the IGA. Is that, can I get a verbal yes on that?
Yes.
And,
yes.
And the second, yes. Yes. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I would like to amend the motion. I would like to amend the motion to change the reference to July 21st, 2011 to whatever the appropriate date is of the presidential election 2012.
We have a motion to amend.
Commissioner Bob, just a clarification, that would go to the date that we hold the special election, or go to the election?
Yes.
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
We have a motion to amend. Motion dies for lack of a second. There's no further discussion. We vote on the main motion. And that motion passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos having recused himself. Counselor, I think I'll refer to the...
Mr. Chairman, at this point, I believe it would be appropriate to turn this matter over to the city mayor and city council.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the commission. Just a little insight to address Commissioner Levent's thought process in reference to some streets. All of their projects are regional projects that we propose on our list. And when I say regional, it's not a city street that dead ends. Most of it, well, I can tell you that we have $2 million in park and recreation. We have $10.5 million in roads and intersections. And the majority of those roads and intersections are State Route 20 and Caramel Road. That's a terrible intersection, is to redo that. All the way through to Maple Street intersection and State Route 20, Castleberry Road and State Route 20, Veterans Memorial and State Route 20, all the way to State Route 9. So that's a major portion. And also, the other intersection that's going to be a major player is the intersection of Van Street, Ridgecrest, and Highway 9. Straight out the road a couple of blocks where you turn to go to the hospital. That needs to be signalized, turning lanes and all. And that's another that we're working with the DOT on. That's the one. And I have left a copy at a previous meeting with the boards with the reference to all of our other projects. Originally, the city
We were talking about maybe $240 or $250 million originally, and when it was cut down to $200 million originally, we had like $30 million worth of road projects in the City of Cumming and Park and Rec. That would do some major road work that would connect to county roads. And like I said, these are all regional. Nothing is within dead-end streets in the City of Cumming. So that hopefully will benefit not only traffic congestion in these intersections, but it'll help improve traffic and flow through Cumming and Forsyth County. So with that said,
yes, sir. I understand that those are good projects, and I thought I'd commented to them. Oh, I actually used some of those. My comment was also to just curb appeal. Maybe some of the roads in your street lights and maybe some cobblestone walks and that kind of curb appeal when you come to town and just dress it up, or just attract the town that might attract more business and folks coming into your city to.
And I like that concept. I like that. We did a lot of that back in 1994 when we did the street improvements around the courthouse square, did all the sidewalks and stone, colored stones.
Yes,
so that was done out of SPLOST, and we got some state aid at that time, but there's no state aid anymore. But anyway, thank you. Thank you all, your commissioners. And at this time, the board has voted unanimously with Commissioner Amos abstaining on the IGA. I had previously said to pass the resolution first, but with the commissioners approving the intergovernmental agreement, which the document spells out the process of which the projects will be implemented and the split, and also so does the resolution. And I would recommend to the board that Chairman entertain a motion that we accept the proposal that's been presented to us by the Board of Commissioners unanimously. What's the pleasure of the board?
I have a motion. I second.
I have five motions.
I have a second.
All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Councilors, any more business to the city?
The only question I have is fairly procedural for the city. If they wanted to adjourn their meeting and take leave of us, they could, or they could say it's up to you, Mr. Mayor.
I also have a resolution that was sent over that while we have convened the city council of the City of Cumming, also the resolution, I feel important that it's important that we also adopt it while we're in session here. And so, Chair, I entertain a motion to the resolution that's been agreed to by the Board of Commissioners.
Make a motion.
Have a motion from Rupert. Have a second. Second from Quincy. In discussion. Please vote on it, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. I hear a motion to adjourn.
Make a motion.
Second. All in favor, signify. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Thank you, Board.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Council.
Appreciate you coming, Board.
Thank you.
Number two calls for the adoption of a resolution calling for an election. Do you want to take that up now, or do you want to go back to the adoption of the consent agenda?
I'd like to go back to the regular order of the agenda. We'll get to that in due course.
All right, thank you, Council.